are watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
For the community, by the community.
Women are rising. They're awakening to their dreams and their destinies. They're taking their place in the kingdom. They're claiming their voice. What is this global awakening, this global phenomenon just all about? Don't touch that remote. I'll be right back to tell you all about it.
Get ready to find hope. Get ready to be inspired. Get ready to discover your full potential. Get ready for total success from the Total Success Coach, Princess Bola Adelani.
This is Princess Bola Adelani welcoming you to Inspired Success, your monthly dose of inspiration power. Yes. The program that equips you with the power and inspiration for total success. That is success at work and in life. Yes, it is a global awakening, a global phenomena. It's women. It's about women rising. They're getting up. They're being roused from their slumber and they're rising up and they're saying, taking their place. They're claiming their voice. And they're rising to their destinies. What is this all about? Well, don't touch the remote. We're going to be talking about that today on Inspired Success. And I'm not in the studio by myself. I have some amazing women, just two amazing women, you know, two amazing women on the forefront of women empowerment, both in the faith community and in the business community. And they're with me to talk about the challenges that come with this awakening. They're here to talk with me about, you know, how women can better position themselves and what it's all about. And it gives me great, great, great pleasure to welcome to Inspired Success my dear, very dear friend and colleague, Miss Annie Garland.
Hello, Princess Bola. It's an honor to be here today. Thank you.
Oh, my pleasure. Anytime. You do amazing work, and we're going to be talking about that in a second.
Thank you.
And next to her is another colleague of mine, a woman of faith, a woman of destiny, a leading woman, and she's none other than Miss Bestie Roy.
Yeah.
And she is, and she'll be telling you more about what she does, but she's the national director of a national organization mm-hmm. called Women of the Word.
Yes, thank you for having me today. It's a blessing to be here.
Yeah, so yeah, anytime. My pleasure. So we're going to drive right first into this conversation, you know, and I get asked this question all the time. So I'm going to pose it to you.
Okay.
What inspires and drives your passion for women empowerment? And then you can, you know, just tell people, what viewers, what you do, what it is you do, and what then drives that?
I'll go first.
Okay.
What I do, Princess, very similar to what you do, is I create and produce events for women. Women who are seeking change, finding purpose, and wanting to move forward.
Yes.
And I give women hope.
Yes.
Taking them out of their fear-based situations and moving them forward.
And so what inspires that? You know, what inspires that passion? I believe it's a passion of yours.
It is.
You know, I have been in the business as well for a long time. And I know that sometimes, you know, financially, it's not that it really, you know, adds up, mm-hmm. you know. It's not necessarily very financially lucrative. But, you know, it's emotional, it's spiritual, it's fulfilling something here, at least for me. And I believe that's the same for you. So what drives you? What inspires that? Why? How did you get into this mm-hmm. whole, you know, self-improvement, women empowerment industry?
This is a two-hour show, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see, the Reader's Digest version. I come from the corporate background. I've been in corporate for years and years and years. Mm-hmm. And through mergers and acquisitions, I found myself out of work. Mm. I've been working with women all across the country for years. And I would hear the same stories when I would have lunch with these women. And they would say that they were having issues, their maybe empty nesters, and they're wanting to change their careers, or, you know, they're looking at their bodies in the mirror and they're saying, I need a change, or maybe they want to go deeper and be more spiritual. Mm. And yes. So those were the three areas that I created pillars for, were the foundation for my events. And so that gives me impetus. I love getting up every morning and thinking about how I can help women help themselves.
Yes. And for you, Betsy, why women? And, you know, how did you fall into this leadership role where you're now leading, you know, a national organization and creating all these wonderful, life-changing seminars and conferences all over the around the country? How did you get into that? What informs that?
Well, I first actually attended a Women of the Word event in Springfield, Massachusetts in 1998, so about 15 years ago. And I went as an attendee at the invitation of a friend of mine who I really saw had grown in the Lord, and she was kind of an informal mentor to me.
Yes.
So when she said come, I knew that I had to go because I saw things in her that I wanted,
yeah,
you know.
Absolutely.
And so I went to the event and I began to see women really from all different denominations and from different backgrounds and of different ages really coming together, so much as the Bible says that from every tribe and every nation we will be before the Lord.
Yes.
And began to see that many women really have deep places of hurt and barrenness in their life. They're very barren.
That's true.
And in Isaiah it says, sing, O barren woman. And so I began to see that as we follow the Lord and as he shows us his life and gives us abundant life, that is his desire. He is the life.
Yes.
And he gives us abundant life. That as we follow him, those places of barrenness can really be watered upon and be ministered to.
Mm.
And God will bring forth through him that which he has destined us to be and desired us to be.
And so, you're saying the same thing. You saw a need,
yes.
You know. Your exposure to women made you realize that there were certain needs. Women have certain needs, deeper needs.
Yes.
You know, nothing, we're not talking superficial now, but the deeper things. You know, deeper issues, esteem issues, wanting change, wanting to improve and be better and heal and all of that. And, you know, I can relate to that because, you know, I get asked that question as well often. You know, so why women, Princess Bola? And I say to them, it comes from my own personal place of brokenness as well. You know, I lost my mother when I was just 18. And so I never really had a mentor mother figure in my life. And I had to really navigate life myself as a young woman. And now I'm in this place where, you know, I feel like I'm in a better place. And so I want to give back.
Yeah.
I want to help my sisters. I want to help others to come out of their brokenness and their pain and their own issues and find a stronger place and get into a stronger place. So, you know, like you, I've been doing this for decades, for years, you know, in so many different capacities.
Mm-hmm.
As a vocation, as a full-time vocation, I've been doing it for almost 8 years. And, but I've noticed something very recently, you know, I would say in the last couple of years, there is an increase, you know, there is a sudden upsurge in the number of women who are rising, who are saying, you know what? I'm tired of being, you know, tired, sick and tired, kind of. I want more. I want to, there's more. And what do you say is responsible for that, Anne? Why are women rising?
Well, I think this pot has been boiling for years, and it's just been bubbling at a low-grade flame, and it's starting to rise. That's us bubbling. We are finding our voices. We are tired of being oppressed.
Yes.
We want more, and I think through the community of women, as you had your loss, I lost my mother when I was 26, so I never really had somebody there for me either.
Yes.
I grew up with three brothers and a sister who was way older, but this community of women that's happening now, we come together and we can make a lot of magic. We can make a difference.
Absolutely.
Together.
Absolutely. We're stronger together. Absolutely.
Yeah.
And so there are a couple of things you said that stand out. So you're saying they're tired of being oppressed. That was the word that you used. And I like that word because people would not necessarily agree, you know, that women are being oppressed. You know, when people think of oppression, they think of, you know, like the civil rights, you know, that kind of real negative, deep oppression. But, you know, now we're in the 21st century, at least in America, and we've kind of moved away. We've had the feminist movement.
Right.
There are all kind of laws, anti-discrimination laws and all of that. And so we should be thinking that really women are not being oppressed. So
Well, I was just going to add one more thing, and then I'd like to hear Betsy, too.
Yes.
I look at it as we've been looking through a window at the world,
mm-hmm.
and now this window has become a big picture window, especially with what's going on in Afghanistan and with all the women around the world.
Yes.
That has really brought to the forefront what's happening out there, that we are now saying we are lucky as American women.
Yes.
And yet we've had some influence of what's coming from outside world here.
Yes.
And
it's actually started here. Actually, it did exist here. Mm-hmm. Are you talking about in terms of how women are programmed and how the culture has kind of programmed women into certain roles and a certain place? Oh, definitely started here as well. You know, our history dates back, you know, way before the Victorian era.
Yeah.
And you know, absolutely. So now let's talk about church women.
Yes.
Let's talk about church women. And let's stay with that word oppression.
Okay.
Let's stay with that word oppression. It's a very powerful word. It's a word that we don't like to use.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think church women are being oppressed? And why do you think are church women rising? And do you think they are also, there's some form of oppression? And why do you think they're rising if you think they do?
Mm. Well, I think traditionally there is a church hierarchy, so to speak, which is primarily still run by men, primarily.
Patriarchal, yes.
Yes, but I think the Lord has a different way, because he tells us in his word that men and women together are created in the image of God. So we are the image of the Lord just as well. And it says in the Psalms that the Lord gives the word, but great is the company of women that arise and give the word and that will proclaim his word. And so I see women, especially in the faith-based community.
I'm just going to stop you there because you just used the word proclaim.
Yes,
and here
proclaim.
Is Princess Bola Royal Proclamations.
Amen.
I'm a proclaimer,
yes,
you know.
Yes.
But anyway, go
but
on.
But how do we proclaim? We proclaim, yes, by the words that we say, but we proclaim more by the life that we live.
Yes, true, true.
Proclamation through, and I think women are coming more into an understanding of that. They have an effect more so than men many times within the family, within the community, and even within the workplace, within the marketplace. Wherever we have an effect.
Yes, but you haven't really answered my question, though.
Okay. How are they oppressed?
Are they oppressed?
I think they are oppressed.
Okay.
Yes.
And why do you think they're rising now?
Because I believe the Lord is bringing together into the final days the showing forth his image through men and women together. And so the women may be arising more now. Men have arisen in many areas of the church for a very long time. But women now are coming, I believe, alongside to show that it's not just about men and it's not just about women. It's really about the two together.
Yes, it is absolutely. It is, and we're going to talk about that. And absolutely, you're right. I think whether it's culture, you know, mainstream society, or whether it's religion, women are being oppressed, Women are being oppressed. And that sense of oppression is just quickly, just simply means, you know, being subdued. It's a sense of, you know, saying, you know what, you know, trying to fit them into a certain box and a certain mold. And what happens, what I think happens, and why we see women suddenly rising is that after a while you get uncomfortable. And that box begins to get, you know,
tight,
too tight. And it's like how your clothes, you wear some clothes and it's so tight and it's so uncomfortable. The natural reaction is just a natural reaction is that you're going to at some point want to take it off. You're going to shed it off.
Didn't we burn our bras?
They were
trying to rise then.
They've always tried to
still
rise.
Still wearing mine.
But yes, I think that is more of the issue. They are rising because of this programming that they are saying there is more to me than meets the eye. I am all that. Yes, I am a woman in, for the your mother. I am a homemaker. I am the cook. I am the nurturer. I am the, you know, I satisfy the you as a man. So whatever, I am all of that, but there's also more to me than that. So that is what they're saying. They're not saying, you know what, we are no longer, and I think that's the difference between the last movement that we had and this one, where they were actually discarding the entirety of who they were as women. This generation of women rising are embracing their femininity. They don't have a problem.
I love my woman.
I know. They don't have a problem being girls. That's they love their lipsticks. You know, they love their high heels. They love their jewelry. But at the same time, they're saying, you know what? I'm not a dumb blonde. I'm not just all of that. I'm more. I'm this intelligent woman as well.
We're not just pretty faces. No,
exactly. There's more to me to do and so on and so forth. So that is why women are rising. And if you're just tuning in, you're tuning into a very animated, energetic conversation with Annie Garland and Betsy Roy. Betsy Roy of the Women of the World, Annie Garland of Idea Circle for Women. And we're having this conversation about women rising, this global phenomenon. I say it's global because I'm seeing it across the globe. You mentioned Pakistan with Malala, and we're seeing it, you know, in North Africa, in Egypt, in Saudi. It's everywhere. I recently got connected with women in the Caribbean islands. So it's everywhere. It's a global thing where women are beginning to say, you know, no.
I'm not going to take it anymore.
Absolutely. So. Thank you for putting it that way. Now, let's talk about the challenges. Let's talk about the challenges. Because, you know, women are rising, but with this awakening, I think there come certain needs and certain challenges and that are going to face women. And so, you know, they're enthusiastic, but when the reality, rubber meets the road, the reality is that, you know, I wasn't expecting this. I wasn't expecting the resistance. I wasn't expecting to fail, you know. And so what do you think, number one, women should expect? What are some of the challenges that come with this awakening? So
I think most of the challenges that I have found primarily, there are some challenges in the church, in bringing the church together across denominations and them not feeling threatened by one another. So there are those challenges. But I think for women specifically, the primary challenge is right here between the two ears. It's in their mind. It's a lot of feelings of inferiority that they have to deal with. Their own self-esteem. That because their self-esteem is not, I feel, rooted in the Word of God and in the Lord. So the self-esteem are big issues. And so a lot of the blockage that comes is really things that may be societal, but there are things that we, our own thinking, for example.
Our thinking has to be changed.
Exactly. The stinking thinking has to be changed. And the thinking that is comes from the Word of God
has to be
is
aligned.
A different
Absolutely.
Thinking.
Yes.
And so that we, God says His ways are higher than His our ways. His thoughts are higher than our thoughts. So when we align our thinking,
yes.
and begin to change even the words that we're speaking.
Absolutely.
That those will help us overcome a lot okay. of our own obstacles.
Okay, so we are our own greatest obstacles. And
yes.
everything, a lot of it has to do with the mind. So
yes.
you've really identified one major one. And one way of solving that is get aligned in the Word. Renew your mind. And
exactly.
that's where your organization comes in, right?
Yes, absolutely.
And you have programs. Tell us a little bit about the kind of programs you have to really help women get in the Word and realign their minds with God's Word. And mm-hmm. it's a question of identity.
Yes, identity
is huge. Where they begin
huge.
To really know who they truly are
yes.
and not measure themselves against their material and externals,
right.
but more of their inner identity and relationship
yes.
with God.
Yes.
And so tell us about a lot
well,
of your programs, and especially
yes.
the one coming up
in September
because
okay.
we only have a few more
okay.
minutes.
So
and I
quickly.
Want viewers to be able to tap into a lot of
yes.
all these resources that are
yes.
here today in the studio.
Yes.
So it's Inspired Success, and you know where to go, royalproclamations.com, and you'll be able to link all of this amazing women and their resources. So tell me about that very quickly.
Well, identity is key, what you said, because many
yes.
women identify their identity by what the world tells them that
yes.
they should be and not how the Lord shows us.
Because yes.
the Bible says we are complete in Christ.
Absolutely.
And so we need to come into alignment with that. So our programs, whether it's a one-day event, which we had in Connecticut last year,
mm-hmm.
or our weekend event, which is coming up in September 20th through 22nd.
So you heard that.
Yeah.
September, say that again.
September 20th.
Look into that camera. Let
September
them hear
20th
that.
Through 22nd.
Because, you know,
yes.
we want this to be a lasting awakening.
Absolutely.
We want it to be intentional, informed, educated.
Yes.
We don't want an emotional mess.
That's right.
You know, and so part of that
yes.
is we want to educate and empower and renew the mind. And so you have this event September 20th to the 22nd
Correct.
At the
Marriott
Windsor.
Yeah, in the Windsor. Marriott. The Marriott in Windsor, right
okay.
off of, on Day Hill Road there, off
yes.
of 84.
And so close. What, it's just speakers?
Well, we have speakers. We're actually having some dance teams coming
oh,
as well.
Oh, nice.
And
women like fun.
Yes,
girls,
yes.
girls just want to have
oh,
fun.
Yes.
You know, we do. And,
yes.
and that's what I'm saying is unique about this new generation of women awakening. You know, they're girly girls. They still like their fun and makeup
yes.
and hair and dance. And they still like that. They're
yes.
cool with that. You
yes.
know, they're doing all their rising in high heels.
Mm-hmm. Well, we want to have fellowship and fun.
Yes.
And we want to have times of worship
of course.
With the Lord. But what we really want is them to be changed.
Yes.
And change comes through learning the Word of God and knowing how the Word of God will change you and transform you.
Absolutely. And so it's a whole day
yes.
of, you know, because you can learn in a relaxed atmosphere of worship, fellowship,
yes.
learning.
Yes.
And yeah.
Yeah,
yes.
well, we start on Friday evening and we end at noon on Sunday. But you can also come for just all day Saturday.
Yes.
But it's as we learn the Word of God and as we are, as that is revealed by the Holy Spirit, because we need both. We need the Word of God and the Spirit of God to reveal His Word and
Absolutely.
Teach us.
So be lifted up September
yes.
20th to 20th, 20th to 22nd, womenoftheword.net. And so you tell me, Annie. We have only a few minutes left. What are some of the challenges that you see with the awakening? And tell us about your program that I can't yeah. wait to attend on October 1, October 1st.
Yes. Well, I think it's finding our power, getting in touch with your internal power, finding your voice.
Mm.
And I think the challenge is getting over your fear.
Mm.
I think everything, if it isn't love, it's fear.
Yes.
Everything is fear-based.
Yes.
And so, and that's...
And so your own events help really to help them to overcome their fear, empowers them.
Well, to find their voice, to look within and see what areas that they need help in. As I described, I have three pillars that identify my events.
Okay.
Career, body, health, and spirit. So every woman is looking for some change in one of those areas at any point in their life.
Yes.
And my event that's coming up October 1st, it's in New Haven.
I know,
Anthony's,
I love the fact that you have it here.
View.
Oh, beautiful facility.
Paradise by the Sound.
I know.
And it's just steps to the beach, so if you wanted to sneak out of a workshop, you could just, toddle on down
Absolutely.
The beach.
Absolutely.
I mean, every one of my events are near water.
Yes,
always.
It's
that's,
a beautiful
I don't know why,
location.
But they're there. And so I have 24 speakers, incredible leaders
I know,
in their
I
field.
I know, experts, I know some of them are my colleagues and amazing dynamic speakers and October
Something
1.
For everyone.
And
really.
That's ideacircleforwomen.com?
No, actually,
it's your name.
It's my name, and I pronounce my name Annie, but I spell it A-N-N-E.
Okay.
So it's A-N-N-E GarlandEnterprises.com.
So you got it. October 1. And I also have an event coming up in the fall for you. Okay.
Yeah.
So, hey, because some of the issues and the challenges that come up with this awakening that I have observed is really a question of identity.
Yes, it is.
And it is also a question of training, mm-hmm. of empowerment. And so I've come up with two programs. The first one is to help people discover who they are innately. Discover your uniqueness, your authentic self, discover your identity in Christ. You discover your gifts and your calling and your passion, first. And so that retreat is coming up October 24th, through the 26th at Our Lady of Calvary Retreat Center in Farmington, Connecticut, October 24 to 26th. Then after that, in the new year, I'm launching a new program to really help to empower women to thrive in whatever it is that they're called to do, whether that be the marketplace, whether that be in ministry. I feel like women need more, mentoring. We use the word mentoring, but the Bible calls it discipleship.
Yes, discipleship.
They need more discipleship. They need someone close by showing them and, guiding them through the process of the transformation and awakening. So you got it. I mean, it's just been so much fun, such a great honor having you.
Well,
and, we want to talk in closing about how I noticed that this somehow is a threat to men. Men somehow see these as a threat. And I want to talk to my male viewers, and say to them, don't be threatened by women rising. The rising up of a woman does not necessarily mean the diminishing of the man.
That's right.
It just means that we're rising to an equal place of power. And together as partners, as joint heirs, we will revolutionize the world. We'll change the world.
And isn't it true? If women are happy, their homes are happier.
Exactly.
I mean, the children are happy. The husband's happy.
Exactly.
It's a beautiful thing.
Absolutely. And we're not trying to displace anybody.
No.
We're not. It's not about displacing them. It's about getting to that place of power with them. Where we are strong.
Together.
And we can equally deliver, and really help them as well. And together as a team, we can change the world. That's what it's about. So, hey, don't feel threatened. Encourage your mother, your sister, your aunt,
That's right.
your fiance, whoever. Encourage them to be a part of all these great events, or even treat them, register someone, because it only means they're going to come back stronger for you, better equipped for you, ultimately they'll be better off. So it's October 1 for Annie. I call you Annie.
It is Annie.
It's Annie. September 20th to 22nd for Betsy. Okay. Mine is October 24th to 26th And all of this information is available at royalproclamations.com. You know where to find me. Twitter, I'm there. I'm everywhere.
Facebook.
All over the place. She's everywhere.
Facebook, LinkedIn. And then you're going to catch me around town too, you know. Yes. And, you know, this is Princess Bola. I just saying, you know what?
Thank you.
Thank you, ladies,
thank you
for being here and just being a part of this very, you know, inspiring and much needed conversation. And to you, my viewers, I want to say thank you. You know, I love you. Thank you for tuning in. And I'm reminding you, as usual, to keep smiling. Come on, put a smile on your face. Life's too short.
No pickle
buses. Put a smile on your face. Keep networking. Keep believing, keep learning, keep on keeping on. You're on the winning side. I'll see you next month with another amazing broadcast.